5 seconds to go. Start. Sir, the price situation in our country is only a mirror of the economy as a whole and the policies which are driving the economy. So, there is no use either complimenting our finance minister or running him down. Ever if the same finance minister was the minister of industry in Tamil Nadu now as he was before, I do not know what he would have done. It is not an individual's capacity or efficiency or inefficiency, sir, but it is the policy. What is the policy towards our economy, towards the trade, towards distribution, towards production, and so on? All these combined together have resulted in this situation. The more important thing is our policy towards our exports and imports. If the House examines carefully our policy and analyses our exports and imports and the price structure of our exports and imports, it will come to the inevitable conclusion that the imperialist countries are looting our country much more than what the Britishers did during their rule in this country. A few days ago, sir, the Honorable Minister of Commerce and the leader of this house was giving us some details with regard to tea. Whether it is tea or coffee or any other consumer goods that we export, we only export at the cost of the consumers of this country. For every kilogram of tea that is exported, our country is losing about 4 to 6 rupees. Who is bearing the burden? The burden is shifted to the consumer. Every man or every woman or every child who takes tea in our country has to pay for the export. The export earning is going down. The same is the case with regard to coffee. Now, sir, we are exporting all sorts of things, meat, fish, fruits, everything we export. All consumer goods are being exported to earn dollars to pay for foreign debts. This is one of the main reasons for this increase in prices of consumer goods. The basic policy must be changed. We should fight for a reversal of the price structure in the international market. That is where the role of our country becomes very important, being one of the biggest countries in the world. We are playing an important role in international politics. Our country plays an important role in the non-alignment. The same role must be played here for the world peace. Whatever is produced is partly consumed for export and partly for hoarders and black marketeers. Hoarders and black marketeers are responsible for high prices. How to check this menace? I spoke about the essential articles such as food grains, sugar, etc. Is this the strategy to tackle high prices and hoarding? The hoarders will not part with the hoarded stock, and the government is so powerless to take over the hoarded stock. They have to import. But how much can you import, and who will pay for these imports? There is more than 26 lakhs tons of sugar available with the millers. I do not know the figure about food grains that is lying hoarded. You have no courage or the policy or the moral strength to take that. The entire people will support you if such a bold decision is taken to bring out the hoarded stock, particularly the working class and the rural poor will support such a policy. Yesterday, we discussed about cement in this house. The government says that the price of cement is Rs. 129, but it sells for Rs. 170 a bag. Building workers are going without employment. Only black marketeers are purchasing cement at that price. So the black marketing, black money and high prices are the symptoms of a disease. This disease is deeper in our economy because our policy is to make the rich richer. Have any of these monopoly houses suffered due to high prices? Take the accounts of the monopoly houses. Their assets have grown and their profits have increased. Their investments have increased. The finance minister will try to excuse himself by saying that I am speaking about the ideology. But ideology is necessary. Our nation has an anti-imperialist ideology. We have an anti-capitalist ideology. Our ideology is the not pro-capitalist, pro-imperialist. Our ideology is the ideology of the Indian people, the working people. It is so from the Karachi resolution. As a nation, we have evolved that policy. That is what I am asking you. So, I do not want you to use this thing for politics. You have to decide which class you are going to defend and which class you are going to attack. Unless we are clear about it, which party rules is not the point. If they pursue the same policy, nothing is going to happen and the situation will be worse. I will appeal again to do something to strengthen the public distribution system, at least save the people from starvation. Immediately, he will say that there are no starvation deaths because no death is reported as starvation death in the country. Stop.